Hello viewers. While talking about the real-time QPCR, in our previous videos, we have already discussed about the methods that use the fluorescent dye or the DNA binding dyes. These DNA binding dyes, they may bind themselves at the minor groove of the DNA duplex, or they may be present in the form of intercalating molecules within the DNA duplex. Then, apart from that, we have already discussed the hydrolysis probe-based methods. And in this hydrolysis probe-based methods, the various probes that we have already discussed, they are the linear probes, that is the Tachmann technique, and the molecular beacon. To enhance the specificity of this method, instead of linear probes, we use this hairpin loop-like molecular beacons that had the fluorescent molecules. Now, in this video, we will be talking about the scorpion probe. This scorpion probe, it also has got a stem and loop structure, but the basic difference between this molecular beacons and the scorpion probes is that the complementary sequence of the molecular beacon, it was similar to some of the sequences of the target DNA. Even in scorpion probes, this loop structure, it has got complementary sequences, but the characteristic feature of this scorpion probe is that it is attached to the 5 prime end of the PCR primer itself. So, right from the very beginning of this PCR, as soon as this primer it anneals to the target DNA, even this scorpion probe it attaches itself to the target DNA molecule. Now, after that, what happens? Come on, let us see. Now, basically, what are the basic parts, components, or elements of a scorpion primer probe? This scorpion primer probe, or it is also referred to as the scorpion or the scorpion probe, it has got the complementary sequence. Then it has got the stem loop structure. And in the stem loop structure, it has to have the two inverted repeats of 5 to 6 base pairs. Then, in this two, the quencher molecule is present on the one end of this stem, and on the other end is present the fluorophore. This fluorophore, or the fluorescent reporter molecule, is present. In this way, the two ends of this stem loop structure, they are very much similar in case of molecular beacon as well as the scorpion probe. But in case of scorpion probe, the extra part is the blocker, which is attached at the 5 prime end of the primer and attaches this stem loop structure to this primer part. Now, what is this blocker? Blocker is basically a chemical molecule that prevents the amplification or prevents the replication of this part of the probe molecule. So, whenever TAC polymerase, it will start with the elongation phase, with the extension phase, at that time only this primer it will be replicated, that is, extension will take place at the 3 prime end of this PCR primer, which is attached to this molecule of our probe by means of this blocker molecule. So, This blocker is the chemical that attaches the fluoropore region with the PCR primer. Now, these are the basic elements which ought to be present in the Scorpion primer. That is, a specific probe sequence has to be there. Then the complementary stem sequences, they have to be there. Fluorophore attached at the 5 prime end and quencher joined at the 3 prime end of this stem structure. And then after, this 3 prime end is linked to the 5 prime end of the primer, and that too via a PCR stopper. So these basic components, they may be present in two formats. One is the UniProbe. The UniProbe, it has got this loop-like structure which joins or connects both these segments of this probe, one having the reporter and the other having the quencher. However, it is also possible that this loop sequence is not in the form of a loop. This complementary sequence is present on one of the part of this, the molecule, that is the reporter part, quencher part, and the other part is free. That is, see over here, the biprobe structure. The complementary sequence is here with the quencher molecule, and this reporter sequence is attached to the PCR primer by means of a blocker. The loop is missing in this biprobe structure. So it may be in the form of a stem loop UniProbe structure, or it may be in the form of a biprobe. Both of them, they are the types of Scorpion primers or Scorpion primer probes. Now, how this Scorpion primer probe, it actually helps us to analyze the quantitative part of this real-time PCR. That is, how we can know the amount or the quantity and quality of our amplicons that are produced because of PCR. So what happens is, we know that in PCR, the first point is denaturation or melting of the target DNA. And when this target DNA at higher temperatures, it melts, the two strands of the DNA duplex, they separate from each other. At that point of time, the primer that is attached at this 3 prime end of our Scorpion probe, it will form complementary base pairing with the target single-stranded DNA molecule. And then in the extension phase, the TAC polymerase, it will add the nucleotides one at a time, the complementary nucleotides, and this will this single stranded DNA molecule, it will become a duplex molecule. But as soon as the complementary part of this DNA is synthesized, the part complementary to the loop structure, at that point of time, this bonds between the two inverted repeats of the stem region, they open up because the heat, it denatures even a probe, and this complementary region of the loop, it forms the double bond, it forms the hydrogen bonds or duplex region with the newly synthesized DNA molecule. Now, when this separates from each other, and even at the time of lowering of the temperature, these two ends, the quencher and the fluorophore, they are not in close proximity because this loop has already formed the double bond, the double-stranded structure over here. So we will be able to detect the fluorescence of this fluorophore. And in this manner, the more the number of amplicons they are produced, that means more the number of primers they will be used for the purpose. And as soon as this amplification takes place, it will form complementary base with this, and a complementary base pairing will take place. And this fluorescence, it won't be quenched by FRET by this quencher molecule, and it will be detected by our system. So this is the process: denaturing, then annealing, and then extension. So this is the basic PCR technique in which, for quantitative and qualitative analysis, the primer having the fluorescent molecules, the two chromophores, quencher and the reporter, it is attached to the primer sequence. Now, in this part of our diagram, this mechanism is made all the more clear. Like, this is the single-stranded template. The primer, it anneals to it. This primer is attached to a stem loop structure by means of a blocker. And as the extension takes place, this part of the DNA that is shown over here in this orange color, it is complementary to the nucleotide sequence, oligonucleotide sequence present in this loop part of the scorpion probe. So this scorpion probe part, it will form the duplex with this newly synthesized template, the daughter DNA part. And now this quencher and the reporter, they are not in close proximity with each other because this loop structure, it has opened up. And the emission of this fluorophore, it will be detected by the system. So more the number of amplicons produced, more will be the fluorescence, because the this probe part attached to the primer, it will emit fluorescence. Now this is the case with both types of probes, that is the uniprobe as well as the biprobes. In uniprobe mechanism, as we have seen just now, this is the newly synthesized DNA strand, and it will form the double-stranded or the duplex part with the loop sequence, thus separating the quencher and the reporter. And instead of the uniprobe, if we use the scorpion's biprobes, in that, to this reporter is attached this PCR primer by means of a blocker, separated by a blocker. And as soon as the complementary bases, they are synthesized, at that time this quencher, it will form this double-stranded part. And in this manner, it will be separated from this molecule. The quencher and the reporter, they'll be separated from each other, and we will be able to detect the fluorescence that is emitted by this molecule. So the basic mechanism in both type of probes, it remains the same, and we are able to detect even a single base mutation, and that too even if the quantity of the initial DNA is very less, then too we will be able to identify the given sequence, or we will be able to analyze quantitative as well as qualitatively the amplicons, that is the polymerase chain reaction products, in real time. So these were the techniques that are being used, and in case of retrovirus, like your COVID-19 virus, it has got RNA in the form of your nucleic acid genetic material. So in that case, it is the reverse transcriptase followed by real-time quantitative PCR. So one thing should be very clear, that reverse transcriptase part is to produce the DNA target molecule from the given RNA, and the real-time quantitative PCR, that helps us by using fluorescence dye or fluorescent probes to quantitatively and qualitatively analyze the target DNA that is being made use of. Thank you.